Thank you, Mary Ann, and a blessed Palm Sunday. Good morning to you as we gather on this beautiful Sunday that the Lord has once again provided us with. And we pray the Lord would bless your time in his house this morning. If you are a guest or visitor to our congregation, we welcome you in the name of Christ. And we would ask you to sign our guest book, and we do invite you to come back and worship with us again. Our order of service this morning is going to be the Divine Service Study number 3. That will be on page 184 in the front portion of your hymnal. We are still in the season of Lent, so we will omit the Gloria and Excelsis and then the response after the epistle lesson. Also, please note today we are continuing our theme that we've had in our Wednesday evening Lenten services, the Hands of the Passion. Today it will be Hands of Praise, and so our gospel reading is printed in your worship folder. We will not be doing the gospel reading on the back of your worship folder, but I do encourage you, and the Senate the last few years has put the Passion History on this day of Palm Sunday, so during Holy Week, I encourage you to read that to be reminded once again of what our Lord has done. Our opening hymn is 444. It is entitled, No Tramp of Soldiers' Marching Feet. We will stand on the fourth and final verse. beseeching him in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to grant us forgiveness. Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Amen.
50, verses 4 through 9a. The Lord God has given me the tongue of those who are taught, that I may know how to sustain with the word him who is weary. Morning by morning he awakens. He awakens my ear to hear those, who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I turned not backward. I gave my back to those who strike, and my cheeks to those who pull out the beard. I hid not my face from disgrace and spitting. But the Lord God helps me. Therefore I have not been disgraced. Therefore I have set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who is my adversary? Let him come near to me. Behold, the Lord God helps me. Who will declare me guilty? This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
On this Sunday, the fifth Sunday of the Passion, we will read together the epistle reading. It's on the back of your worship folder from Philippians chapter 2. The verses are 5 through 11. We read, "Have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but made himself nothing, taking the form of a servant, being born of men, and being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Will you please rise for our Holy Gospel? The Holy Gospel lesson is in Mark chapter 11. Chapter 11, verses 1 through 11, is found on the inside of your worship folder and will be our sermon text for this morning. "Now when they drew near to Jerusalem, to Bethphage and Bethany, at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, 'Go into the village in front of you, and immediately as you enter, you will find a colt tied, on which no one has ever sat. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, why are you doing this? Say, the Lord has need of it, and will send it back here immediately.' And they went away and found a colt tied at a door outside in the street, and they untied it. And some of those standing there said to them, 'What are you doing, untying the colt?' And they told them what Jesus had said, and they let them go. And they brought the colt to Jesus, and threw their cloaks, and he sat on it. And many spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut from the fields. And those who went before and those who followed were shouting, 'Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David! Hosanna in the highest!' And he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. This is the Gospel of the Lord. We'll confess our Palm Sunday faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. You'll find that printed on page 100. And 91, we confess together.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please be seated. Sunday of the Passion is from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 11, verses 1 through 11. Dear friends in Christ, that American theologian Billy Joel once wrote this in a song. They say there's a heaven for those who wait. Some say it's better, but I say it ain't. I'd rather laugh with the sinners than cry with the saints. The sinners are much more fun. You know, that is the philosophy of many, even Christians. So many think that heaven will be boring. No Xbox or ice cream cones. We read in our Bibles about heaven that there's going to be worship, and we're going to sing and praise our Creator for all the love that He has given to us. Worship, praise, singing. Next, you'll tell me I'll be floating on a cloud playing a harp with dull religious people. No, thank you. Unfortunately, these are the same ideas that keep people from praising God here on earth. Easy excuses are found for the weak soul to stay away from God's house. Worship is boring. The Bible is hard to understand. Who wants to go and sit with bland religious people? Today is Palm Sunday, one of the greatest days in the church year for worship and praise. And as Jesus makes his humble and royal entry into Jerusalem on a donkey, all of the attention is on him as a king. The crowds and the children are singing their praises. Though many today would rather go to hell than to find joy in worship, this Sunday we will learn to find joy in raising to Jesus our hands of praise. Now many think that praising God can only be done on a pew with soft music. But the reality is most of our praising of God takes place outside of this church building. You see, the Palm Sunday praise of Jesus took place outside God's house. We have first the obedient praise of the disciples. Jesus gave them unusual instructions about a donkey that they were supposed to get. And certainly, they had questions. Jesus, how do you know the donkey will be there? How do you know we can take it without asking? But they didn't ask. They didn't question Jesus. They praised Jesus with their obedience. Our world does not give that praise to God. They question why God and His Word and His church have a right to tell us what to do at all. They question how a loving God can allow such heartache in our world. They accuse the Bible patriarchy when it names the man the head of the woman and the woman the helper of man. They question why they can't live together before marriage and why they can't swear if everybody else does. But as believers of God, we praise God with our obedience. Christians obey without questioning Jesus' authority. We live good and clean and decent and honest lives outside the church in the world every day. We don't just say, "Your will be done." We go out and see that Jesus' will is done on earth. This is worship that pleases God. Another way we show our praise is to honor our Lord with the stewardship of our gifts. I mean, look at the Palm Sunday crowd. One person happily gave the use of his donkey, and others took off their cloaks and put them on the colt. And still others spread their cloaks on the road. And another group, maybe having little to give, went out and they cut palm branches as a symbol of Jesus' victory. And they all praised God with their possessions. So here we are, Palm Sunday 2023. And the souls of men and women are dying. People are pushing farther away from the church. And people are going to their graves with no saving faith. Is that our main concern? Or do we worry about ourselves? What about the economy? I mean, interest rates keep going up. My share and your share of the national debt is now $94,000 a person. Can I keep my standard of living? Can we put our shirt in the dirt? Just a little. So that Jesus and the message of forgiveness can march triumphantly into our hurting world. Can we not cut a few palms and have them from our trees of worldly hopes and spray them in His direction and using our hands to praise God with our gifts? That would be great praise for our Savior King. Another form of praise came from the mouths of the Palm Sunday worshipers. And those who went before and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David. Hosanna in the highest." You see, when the praise of obedience and the praise of money is there, the praise of the mouth is going to naturally follow. They were loud and enthusiastic and joyous and happy. And you see, the enemies of Jesus were looking on, watching closely and jealously as these people praised Jesus with their mouths when they weren't in church. Jesus still needs the praise of our mouths. And not just when we're singing in church. He needs the spontaneous, sincere praise of our mouths out in the world where his enemies are listening. You see, no souls are going to be converted by our cursing or arguing. No one will want to come here if we badmouth our church or we're always pessimistic and grumpy. We need to praise our King by confessing the faith to the weak and sinful. We will praise our King by standing up for proper language. We will praise our King when we are friendly to the visitor at church or to the friend we are praying for. Jesus needs the praise of our mouth, not just here at church, but out in the world, especially in the hearing of his enemies. Now you can think that heaven will be boring. If only you think that praising God on earth is boring. You see, on Palm Sunday, there were two groups. Those who praised him and those who hated him. Lord, enter our hearts as King. May our hands praise you with unquestioning obedience. You gave your life for us. May we use our hands and our gifts to praise you. And then with the Holy Spirit working in us and through us, allow our mouths to praise you in the world. And then one day soon, we will praise you in heaven, where our praise will be anything but boring. Amen. Sinner, but that all would turn in repentance to you.
Bless the preaching of your gospel and the administration of your sacraments in mission fields around the world. Convert those who do not yet know Christ, and sustain those who face danger and opposition for the name of Christ. Bless and protect all missionaries as they proclaim Christ boldly in hostile places, and surround their families with your care. Banish from our hearts all prejudice that might hinder our mission work here in our nation or abroad. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, our King, your Son entered Jerusalem as the true ruler, ready to lay down his life for his people. Grant this same mind to those in authority over us, that they would discharge their duty, even for the least among us, and so receive your commendation. Lord, in your mercy. According to your gracious will, O Lord, look upon all who suffer illness or physical disability. Bless them with what is best for them according to your good and gracious will, and strengthen their faith. Lord, in your mercy. Eternal Lord, as your Son once entered humbly into Jerusalem to cry the Hosanna, so send him to us according to his promise in the Holy Sacrament, so that we may eat his body and drink his blood as repentance and faith for the forgiveness of our sins and in the unity of a true confession. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for our brothers and sisters in Christ who were affected this past week by all the tornadoes that went through on Friday throughout our nation. We ask as people continue to pick up their lives and make the repairs that are needed, that your holy presence would be upon them, guide and bless them. We do thank you, Lord, that while tornado watches and warnings were all around us, here in the immediate Bloomington area, we were kept safe. We thank you for watching over us, and we Lord, you would be with us, especially this week, as it looks like more severe storms are on their way. Lord, in your mercy. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We praise you, Father, that you have sent your Son not in wrath but in mercy. As we enter this most holy week and ponder together the mysteries of your great salvation, show us the answer to your people's prayers of Hosanna in the passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Service of the Sacrament, the preface is on page 194. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is truly meet, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who accomplished the salvation of mankind by the tree of the cross, that where death arose, their life also might rise again, and that the serpent who overcame by the tree of the garden might likewise by the tree of the cross be overcome. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and singing. Thank you. Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Now may this true body and true blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen and preserve you in the one true faith and the life everlasting. Depart in peace. Amen.
give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Let us pray. O God, the Father, the fountain source of all goodness, who in loving kindness sent your only begotten Son, flesh, we thank you that for his sake you have given us pardon and peace in this sacrament. And we ask you not to forsake your children, but always to rule our hearts and minds by your Holy Spirit, that we may be enabled constantly to serve you. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The Lord be with you. Bless we the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. When I work here, it's just me and this brick building, not a lot of people around, but Thursday was one of those different days where we had a lot of people in and out of the building all day. I just wanted to take some time to thank our custodian, Roman Lienart, Andy Benjamin, and Jean Fuller. We had a problem in our elevator shaft again, and if we had had to call the elevator people and the plumbers, it would have been hundreds of dollars, and they were able to fix the problem on Thursday, so we are thankful for all the gifts, as we heard in today's sermon, that God's people use for service to the Lord's church. And speaking of Jean, his wife Nancy, today is her birthday, so God's blessings on your birthday today, Nancy. Have a great day. Does anyone have any other announcements this morning? All right, the Lord be with you. Thank you.